no matter what decision you make, no matter what piece of paper you sign, and 3 hours later you can be sure that a new piece of paper will be signed, which will contradict it. Yesterday on Russian television, it was said that my resignation was linked with disagreement with Mr. Yeltsin. I categorically deny that. We have entirely normal relations. We have frequently discussed our problems. I repeat that if the deputy corps in Moscow were to be reelected and if it were to actively support reform, I think that the position of the Russian parliament would be different, and I think that things would be quite different in general. So the decision has been made, and Gavril Popov intends to resign as mayor. So the conflict between the mayor's office and the municipal council is a fact. We can expect that all the orders of administration will be perceived as we can't expect that they will all be just accepted automatically. And most of the Muscovites have put a lot of hope into Mr. Popov. Thinking that this famous economist would help them to overcome all the problems that they're coming up against. Today, continuing the news, was a meeting between the president of Uzbekistan, Mr. Karimov, and Turgut Özal. This is the first such meeting since Uzbekistan declared its independence. Today, the heads of state met here. This is Mr. Özal. The question of lengthy, mutually advantageous trade was discussed. Likewise, the economic reforms of Turkey, which took place 14 years ago, and are called the Turgut Özal reforms, serve to stimulate the private sector, and this experience unconditionally should be taken into account in Uzbekistan, taking into consideration the identicality of roots, of language, and religion, and culture. This could lead to a stable and lengthy cooperation. At the same day, Mr. Karimov met with Süleyman Demirel, Prime Minister of Turkey, and discussed relations between Uzbekistan and Turkey, and Turkey intends to recognize Uzbekistan. The situation is very complex with regard to Mr. Honecker, Erich Honecker. Will he be deported from Russia? And if so, how? And where to? So here are the details from our correspondent. All more and more new countries are getting involved in the Honecker affair. Here we are in the Korean embassy in Moscow, where there is a press conference going on. So the North Korean authorities decided to agree to Mr. Honecker's request. This was the statement of Son Sen-pyer, who said that he hoped that Moscow would answer positively with regard to North Korea's agreement to accept Mr. Honecker as an ailing, aged man. But what if he gets better? The ambassador said, well, we'll have to get him well, better first. In the meantime, Mr. Kozyrev said that the handing over of Honecker to North Korea was being discussed, but Russian authorities have yet to give their agreement. Mr. Honecker currently is in the Chilean embassy as a guest of the embassy. The man who threatened his own citizens with death if they wanted to flee the country, he himself refuses to abandon Russia and even is threatening to commit suicide. Here we have some more information from our video exchange service. Here in Yugoslavia, we see there are tens of thousands of refugees in Slovenia and in Croatia. There are clashes between Croatian units and Serbian partisans, who are being supported by the Yugoslav army. Prime Minister of Poland, Jan Olszewski, presented to Mr. Wałęsa the composition of the new government of Poland. The discussions will be lengthy in nature and probably will take place in two stages today. Here we heard about this from the news agency PAP. In the Netherlands, an international conference was opened on signing a European energy charter. In the conference, participation was there. 49 countries participated, including the Soviet Union and the Commission of European Societies. They discussed the plan of the Dutch government to create in Eastern Europe, and first of all in the former Soviet Union, a situation whereby Western entrepreneurs would be encouraged to invest in energy industries. Today in London, there was an explosion, a very powerful explosion, a few minutes after the police received a warning with regard to bombs planted in all the train stations in London. One was activated not far from a major railway exchange point. We have no information on casualties. According to the Press Association, this was accomplished by the IRA. Experts have come to the conclusion that the reasons for the catastrophe of the Egyptian steamship Salam Express was a result of the fact that the ship got off course and ran into a coral reef and almost immediately sank. Only 170 persons were saved, although there were more than 450 passengers registered in the as being on board. Today, when communications and links between the former republics are breaking up, we see the Inter-Republic Council on Communication here. The greater part of the budget had been spent to ensure communications throughout the country. But what can we do now in the new political situation? Here we saw representatives of the administrations of the various sovereign republics. Are you pleased with the results? Yes, we are. We've come to an agreement that it would be appropriate to create a regional commonwealth on communications. Its supreme body would be the Council of Ministers of Communications, and we have agreed that the Russia would be delegated the authority to represent us during the transitional period in postal and communication affairs. Do you have any disagreements here between television and the Ministry of Communications? No, not really, but it's a complex situation of salaries, fees, all the personnel that we have. So if we have a budget, there won't be any disagreement. Am I right? Yes, you're correct. In Moscow, artists, actors, musicians were given awards. The Minister of Culture of the former Soviet Union, perhaps for the same time, awarded actor, famous figures in the area of the arts. I am deeply convinced that that culture will be a coordinating factor in our country, and we will have to create a center with that regard. Today, theatrical circles are celebrating the anniversary of the great actor Mikhail Chekhov. The grandson of the great actor, who was called a diamond in the crown of the Russian theater, is speaking here. Mr. Chekhov was quite closely linked to the theater, which is now named after Anton Chekhov, the writer. There was a conference where theater directors, teachers, scholars, actors exchanged thoughts on his cultural heritage. He emigrated in 28, and for almost 30 years he lived abroad. In the middle of the 30s, Chekhov created his theatrical groups first in London and then in America. In our country, in the 50s, it was only through Samizdat that you could learn about his work, his writings on actors' technique. So we see a young pedagogue who conducted a lesson using his methodology. So we see motion being very important. So there are many interesting people here. But this is Sofia Stanislavna Pilavskaya, who saw Chekhov on the stage. At the Moscow Art Theater, there's a concert taking place now, a performance where critics are taking place, and actors who are confessing their love and respect for Mikhail Chekhov. No matter whom he respected, the kings or the slaves, he made them all equal in rights. He flung ideas into the audience. People say that the fame of an actor is like smoke, it dies with him. But his glory as the creator of a theatrical system is only now beginning to blossom in our home country. Now, sporting events, and Evgeny Mayor will be our commentator. Thank you. Good evening. Today we see the championship on field hockey. We have the leaders and the outsiders. All the 16 teams had their matches. Here are some of the results. Army from Yekaterinburg.